video classes for the student of Institute of English Shahab Latif University, Kharpur. These video lectures cover the whole scope of English literature, and you will find videos for the subjects of drama, fiction, novel in 18th and 19th century, and American literature as well. For watching more videos, keep on watching my video channel and subscribe my channel. I thank you all and I love you all. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Welcome to the video classes for the students of Institute of English Shahab Latif University, Kharpur. This time, I am here with a beautiful presentation from the subject Modern Novel, and our today's talk is about D.H. Lawrence. David Herbert Lawrence was born in 1885 and died in 1930, and in his short age of simply 45 years, Lawrence left unerasable marks on world literature. He pioneered the style and he wrote with such a vitality and force that all the writers who were his successors were influenced by him, were impressed by him, and followed his footsteps. He is considered as the most remarkable and striking figure in the novel writing. His period of writing lies between two world wars. Means his novels appeared during the period of World War I, and as he died in 1930, he continuously wrote for this period. So his period of writing is between these two wars. He contributed in all genres of literature. If we go through the works of D.H. Lawrence, we come to know that he wrote poetry, he wrote short stories, he wrote travelogues, he wrote dramas, and he wrote all the works of fiction as well as non-fiction. For he wrote travelogues as well, but his rest and fame is for his novel writing. He is considered as the most successful novel writer of his age. When we go through the novels of D.H. Lawrence, we come to know that sex, physical passion, animalism, revolt against modern civilization, human relations are the striking themes of D.H. Lawrence writings. Let me share with you that in one of his novels, his most important novel that is also placed in our syllabus, The Sons and Lovers, he himself writes that his great religion is the belief in the blood. D.H. Lawrence himself writes that his great religion is his belief in blood, because he considers flesh as a wider and wiser than intellect. Taking sex as the greatest human instinct, he expresses his faith in sex in following words. D.H. Lawrence writes, and I quote, "I want men and women to be able to think sexfully. I want men and women to be able to think sexfully, completely, honestly, and clearly," unquote. With the free and fair treatment of sex, sex which was considered as a taboo once, and as he broke this taboo, he is regarded as a modern writer, for he followed the footsteps of Friedrich Nietzsche and he established his name among the modern novelists of his age. Lawrence's first novel appears in 1911, and that novel is entitled as The White Peacock. When we go through the pages of White Peacock, we come to know that in this novel, Lawrence discusses the conflict between man and women. In this novel, Lawrence tells that women are bent upon emasculation of man. Lawrence frequently tells us in his novels that women are bent upon exploiting man. And Lawrence, in his later novels, discusses this theme in detail and tells that how men are kept hostile and how men are kept under the control of powerful women. His second novel, The Trespassers, appeared in 1912. In this novel, Lawrence once again criticizes women. His third and most important novel, Sons and Lovers, appeared in 1913. And ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you that this novel has been placed in our syllabus and we will be discussing different themes and different topics from this novel in my forthcoming videos. And for those videos, you need to subscribe my channel and go through the contents of my channel. In this novel, Sons and Lovers, he discusses human relationships and also explores the theme of Oedipus complex. And now this theme of Oedipus complex that was given by Sigmund Freud, who is considered one of the fathers of modernism, this once again indicates that D.H. Lawrence was a modern writer. In this novel, he investigates human psychology and dives deep into the minds of his characters. He tells that how man and women establish their relations with each other. And he tells that how sons are being influenced by a powerful mother. His most controversial novel, The Rainbow, appears in 1915. This novel discusses sex in detail and was considered as the obscene work by the novelist at that time. And some of the moralists consider it as obscene work, and this work was confiscated and this work was even taken into control by authorities of government. His novel Women in Love is taken as the sequel of his novel The Rainbow, and is in this novel he once again discusses the theme of sex with full freedom and tells us that how sexual relationships are established and how they influence the lives of human beings, and he does so with strong vitality and vehemence. His novel Kangaroo appeared in 1923. His much criticized novel Lady Chatterley's Love was published in 1926. His other novels include The Boy in the Bush, Aaron's Rod, The Plumed Serpent. Besides writing novels, he also wrote short stories, travelogues, essays, and excellent pieces of poetry. Ladies and gentlemen, this shows that D.H. Lawrence was the most prolific writer of his age. He contributed to the great ascent in 20th century, in early period of 20th century, and left his irascible marks on the writings of his successors. Ladies and gentlemen, though some of his novels were considered as obscene during his lifetime, but when we go through the pages of his novels today, we come to realize that it was great insight of D.H. Lawrence. It was his great passion and wide experience of human life that he had explored in his novels. And without any doubt, let me conclude my talk that D.H. Lawrence is considered as one of the most significant, highly admired, highly valuable, and widely quoted and read writer of early 20th century. Thank you very much for watching this video.